charged 51 over here. I hope you're having a splendid day wherever you are in the world. Guys, it is time for round number 7 here for the Canadian Grand Prix here at the Gilles Villeneuve circuit. Guys, unfortunately, one of our upgrades have failed. The power upgrade, an upgrade that I really would have wanted to go on the car for Canada. For Canada being an engine-based track. But it's not the end of the world. We still have a rear downforce upgrade and a reliability upgrade on the car. So it's not the worst thing in the world. We can still manage with what we've got. Guys, looking at the performance chart, it is still Mercedes ahead of Ferrari in second, Red Bull in third. Red Bull are creeping ever closer, even though they have plateaued this weekend. Then it's us, Rich Energy Haas, racing in fourth, with Racing Point closing up very fast towards the rear end of us. So we have to watch out for those two pink cars this weekend. Then it is McLaren in sixth, seventh is Alfa Romeo, eighth is Renault, ninth Toro Rosso, and bringing up the rear end is Rocket Williams Racing. Now, all of that said and done, guys, we have had three brilliant Grand Prix the past three races. Baku, we came second. Circuit de Catalunya, we came fourth. Monaco, we came fourth. Monaco, we actually got a little bit screwed out of a podium thanks to a gearbox issue. We've got a brand new gearbox in the car, ready to go for this. I don't think we've got the pace in the car this weekend to go for a podium, but we've still got reasonable pace, and this is going to be a good weekend. In qualifying, it's going to be a little bit of a wet qualifying. So let's see how we do in the wet weather. I think it's only intermediate conditions, but we're going to scope it out and see what we can do. Let's head to qualifying.
Hello and welcome from the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve, home to the Canadian Grand Prix, for today's qualifying session. So, could be a tasty one today then, Ant. We've got all the ingredients, that's for sure. Treacherous conditions, an ever-changing racetrack, and one or two cars just behind the pace setters who maybe, just maybe, fancy a bit of an upset after a good performance from them in free practice.
And the question has to be, of course, what is that circuit going to look like in 10 to 15 minutes from now? If you think the rain's going to get worse, then you have to be straight out when the lights go green to find whatever grip you can. But if it eases off, then you're better off waiting, saving the tyres, and going out at the perfect moment. The other thing that comes with these conditions? Traffic, and the lack of visibility that comes from sitting in the spray. It's going to be a constant problem, and I expect to see a lot of frustrated drivers with ruined laps out there today.
So guys, here in the pit box, ready for qualifying. I hope you guys are excited for this qualifying session. Guys, just a quick reminder to follow me on all my social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. They're popping up on the screen as we talk. Please go there to stay updated to everything happening here on YouTube and on Turbo Fox Racers. Now guys, this qualifying session caught me off guard. I have to be honest, I was not expecting a wet qualifying session because the conditions only changed right before qualifying. It only would have been cloudy the whole qualifying when I was still busy with the practice sessions, and yeah, it wasn't. So I wasn't ready for this, not mentally. So I had a little bit of a doubt in myself heading into qualifying, but at this stage there was nothing we could really do about it. We had to work with what we had, and you guys can see I overfueled the car quite a lot to go for a consecutive laps, because even though the inters were much quicker than last year's game, on this year's game, I still felt that they had enough pace in them as the session got drier to the end that we could post quicker lap times. The first few laps, I just found out where the grip levels were and how the car was handling in the wet. I did put on one click more downforce on the front wing before we exited the pit box and before we opened up ourselves to the parc fermé rules. So the front wing is set one higher. I left all the rest of my stuff because it was still going to be a dry race, so it would have not been smart to compromise my setup for qualifying, but in the race I was completely slow. And this is not like Spain, where we can have a high downforce setup and eke everything out in the corners. This is a more of a straight line themed track. So we would have been on the back foot significantly, and we would have basically guaranteed ourselves to come away here at Canada without any points. Now, guys, you guys can see we're heading over the line here. This is the end of our second lap. We do a 1:19.7, but we are still P20. From here on, I felt that I could start pushing a bit. You guys can see I'm going a bit high on the ERAs. So I got all faster. You guys can see heading to the end of lap 3, we're already 1 point over a second up. As we go through the hairpin, it goes a bit down. There we go, over a second again. So we were definitely getting faster as the track got better. But this was still not the most comfortable qualifying for me, because we are still P20. Heading down to the final chicane, gonna brush up against the wall of champions. Ooh, okay, actually touch. Don't do that, Turbo, don't do that. Ish! And now we go over the line. We are P17 with a 1:19.2. We got a very terrible run out of the wall of champions, the final chicane. So these final two laps, I was really going to have to push. Guys, also just please remember to drop that all-important like, because that helps out the video so much. So thank you guys for dropping the like. Please drop a like for good luck for the rest of this quali session. We go out to our final lap here in qualifying. Now we're going to go around the Gilles Villeneuve circuit on an intermediate lap. So let's go around the circuit, guys, heading through the first two corners, very tight corners. With it being a wet quali session, you have to be very, very gentle on the throttle. Just a little bit too much throttle, and the car will spin you around. And you guys can see at this stage we are P13, so we're still not away from the danger zone, not far enough away from the danger zone to actually get through into qualifying. So I really needed this final lap to be good, but the problem is I think I took just too much out of my tires with the first four laps, and I really struggled for grip. As you guys can see, they're coming out of the second to last chicane of the track. I just had no grip at all. I'm up by less than a tenth. You guys can see I break early into the hairpin to get a good drive out of the hairpin. We are up by still less than a tenth. We go into the red now. Stuff is not looking good. We are about down to P14. Only us at Giovinazzi are the cars before we get knocked out. Oh, bad. Heading it through the final corner. We have to get something done here. We are 2 tenths down, heading into the corner. Don't hit the wall of champions. We have a little bit of oversteer coming out of the corner, but it's not going to be enough. We are not going to better our lap time. Well, this sucks. We're P18. Oh, boy. Claire's not going to be happy. I mean, not Claire, Emma.
Tough luck there. It's not quite where we'd want to be on the grid, but chin up. It's not the end of the world.
Thank you, Jeff, for taking the blow on me instead of Emma, because Emma would have completely slapped me through the face. So yeah, guys, not the best quali session, but now no points for Saturday. We are going to the race. So guys, let's head to the Canadian Grand Prix at the Gilles Villeneuve circuit.
We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about O'Connor. No grip penalties, no mitigating circumstances, just a poor qualifying performance and a very disappointing start position for them today.
Yeah, it can be very disheartening when you have a bad qualifying session, and even more so when you get to the grid for the race and you can't even see the start line because of all the cars ahead of you. It's just as well that Lucas has a reputation for hard work and determination, as he's going to need both today.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Verstappen, Charles Leclerc, and Faber, Gasly, Butler, Grosjean, and Daniel Ricciardo, Perez, Sainz, Kimi Raikkonen, and Albon, Giovinazzi, Kvyat, Lando Norris, and O'Connor. Russell and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
So, guys, on the grid, ready for qualifying. Guys, as you guys can see, both default strategies are a two-stop. Guys, I actually wanted to try and see if I can do a one-stop. I'm going to go with the game's two-stop strategy and see what happens. But I really think the one-stop, especially in my situation, is the way to go for it. So let's see what happens. You never know what's going to happen. Let's head to the formation lab, and you guys know the drill. Please, jam with me. Mercedes front row lockout. We head to five red lights and it's go, go, go for the Canadian Grand Prix. Brilliant start from Lewis Hamilton on the left-hand side of the track. Now heading into T1, Hamilton has got the jump on Bottas. Bottas is at second and I think that's Charles Leclerc in third position. I'm not sure if it's Vettel or Leclerc, but Hamilton is leading the way for the Canadian Grand Prix so far. The Red Bull of Max Verstappen is in P4 as far as I know. It's either Verstappen or Gasly. As you guys see, Lewis on the soft tyres as well as Valtteri, but the Ferraris have opted for the medium tyres, so they are maybe also doing what I've tried to do and eke out a one-stop strategy. We'll see if the two-stop or the one-stop is faster here at Canada. It's the first time we've been to Canada, so we don't know as far as knowledge goes. It's our first time here, so we are just going to go as we go along. Well, we're going to plan as we go along. We head back to my start, guys, on my POV. You guys can see P18 on the grid on the medium tyres. I get a terrible start. Even George Russell in the Williams jumps me. I block off Kubica and I go for a major dive up the inside. We are 4-1 with me, the Alpha, and both the Toro Rossos. There's a little bit of a tap from Raikkonen into Alpha. He sends me a bit wide, and now it's him and the Toro Rosso who got through on around me, but I did make up at least two positions. Yes, I am in P16. Oh, there goes Alexander Albon. He goes for a little bit of a dive off my inside. The replay just quickly clinches there. Oh, well, clinch jumps. We go up the inside of the second Toro Rosso, which is Danny Kvyat. And now we are heading down here. We have got ourselves all the way up into P15. Not near the points yet. And even the Toro Rosso of Danny Kvyat is putting some pressure on me. I defend the inside and I give him a little bit of a squeeze as we go through. That is the third chicane of the track. And now we head here into the very tight hairpin. The hairpin where Robert Kubica originally had a massive crash. I think it was in 2007. I'm not sure, guys, but if you guys want, go watch that crash on YouTube. One of the worst crashes in F1 history, in my opinion. Guys, we are on the gear. We are close to the gearbox of Antonio Giovinazzi. And now we have to try and get this Haas past that Alfa. And with this 1.05 patch, guys, the Alfa Romeo has been so much better. Oh, I hit the wall of champions coming out of the final corner. I need to stop doing that. My cars aren't going to take much of that, and I think eventually I am going to break my front wing. But like I said, guys, with the 1.05 patch, the Alphas and also the McLarens have gotten a lot faster, as well as racing points. So the midfield is much closer bunched together than it was before the patch. Now, guys, we head on to the end of lap 4, and this is Sebastian Vettel. It was Vettel in P3 chasing after Valtteri Bottas as the soft tires are starting to fall away. Vettel's medium tires are starting to come into play at this very moment, and I think Charles Leclerc is going to be on the back of them very soon. At that stage, Vettel unfortunately could not get the move done. But now we jump back onto my POV, also still the end of lap 4. And finally, we are going for a move on the Alfa Romeo of Antonio Giovinazzi. We are on the outside for the first one. She came on the inside. It's a beautiful move going into the final. She came. Oh, wow! Okay, how do you like that for luck? Giovinazzi has got an engine blowout as we exit the final chicane. So, sorry for Antonio Giovinazzi, who will not be finishing the Canadian Grand Prix. Now, Kimi Raikkonen will be the only Alpha flying the flag for Alfa Romeo. And now, Vettel is once again on the back of Valtteri Bottas. I think this is the end of lap 6 or lap 5. I can't be wrong, guys. Let's just say lap 6. Vettel goes for the move up the inside of Valtteri Bottas on the outside for the hairpin coming out of the first corner into T2. Now they're going to blast down heading into the first chicane of the track, T3 and T4. And Vettel is on the outside, Valtteri on the inside. Vettel will be on the inside for the second part of the chicane. And Vettel squeezes Valtteri to the wall. And Vettel gets the Ferrari up into B2. Heading on to the end of lap 6, guys. You guys can see I am now chasing after the McLaren of Carlos Sainz. Lando Norris is the McLaren behind there, and Sainz is driving brilliantly at this stage. But I go for a move up the inside of Carlos Sainz. It's an easy move into T1, and now we are on the rear end of the only remaining Alfa Romeo of Kimi Raikkonen, who we had a little bit of a bump and rub session at the beginning of the Grand Prix. Now you guys can see Valtteri Bottas is actually coming back at Sebastian Vettel only in the following lap, so he was able to make those tires last long enough to stay with Vettel. And now even Charles Leclerc has gotten himself into this battle with his teammate Sebastian Vettel and Valtteri Bottas. So this is really quickly going to get interesting. Leclerc goes for a move on the outside heading into T1. Vettel is going to defend the inside line. Is Charles going to get past his teammate? Let's see if he does. Vettel's going to have the drive coming out of T2, heading into the first chicane. Vettel's got the outside for the first turn, the inside for the second turn. Charles, come on, what can you do, my friend? And Vettel is maybe going to squeeze Charles out, but as these two are battling, they are letting Valtteri get away, and I think that is all that Valtteri needed, just to get out of the DRS. So Charles Leclerc has maybe just cost the Ferrari a very good chance to get a double podium, but it's still a long race to go, guys. Heading on to the end of lap 7, guys, this is Kimi Raikkonen going after, I think it's Daniel Ricciardo in the Renault. Yes, it is the number 3 Ricciardo. We are going to be 3-1 heading into this final chicane. Raikkonen comes off to block me away. Third gear through the chicane. We make a double move into P11. Let's go, baby. Let's go. We passed Raikkonen and Ricciardo. Oh boy, guys, we have to get a replay of that. This is the POV of the Ricciardo's yellow Renault. And you guys can see Kimi really swerves to the right hand side quite viciously to try and block me off. But there was nothing that Kimi could do. Kimi had the overspeed on Ricciardo, but I had the overspeed on Kimi. Guys, what a double overtake here at Canada. This are the types of overtakes that I live for. That was a brilliant move, to say the least. We have just made a double move. But the bad news is we are still not in a points paying position. So that is not helping our case at all. Now you guys can see here, this is Charles Leclerc still battling away with his teammates. I do not know why Ferrari are battling away. They need to chase after the two Mercedes, who at this stage are dominating this Grand Prix, especially Lewis Hamilton out in front. Charles Leclerc goes for a move around the outside of his teammate, but at this stage cannot get anything done. Let's see if he can get something done on the home straight heading into T1, but I think Vettel is just too far ahead. Heading on to the end of, I think this is lap 9, guys. Lewis Hamilton has... Oh, no, this is Bottas. This is Bottas, not Lewis. So Bottas is getting the pit stop preference, which is quite odd. It's usually the leading car that gets the pit stop preference. But Valtteri is in to strap on. I actually couldn't see, was it mediums or softs? I don't know. This is Max Verstappen coming into the pit lane to strap on his set of medium tires. And now he is also going for a two-stop. This is my teammate Romain Grosjean also strapping on a set of mediums. Guys, this is the following lap. It is lap 10. So Valtteri came in on lap 9. Lewis is coming in on lap 10. And now Lewis is coming into the pit lane to strap on his set of medium tires. So he's also committing to a two-stop. Those mediums will not last to the end of the Grand Prix. I don't care how good your chassis is. Yet Canada with a high wear, there's no way. Now guys, with me staying out on those medium tires and trying to take them as long as possible, this is Lucas Weber passing me. I actually made Lucas go past, guys, because he is on a second stint of soft tires and he has just pitted, and he was quite far ahead of me. So at this stage of the Grand Prix, my race is not with Lucas and I still have to manage my tires. You guys can see just two laps later, the two Red Bulls have caught up to me and Max Verstappen and Pierre Gasly. I let Verstappen go past, and it was my idea to just let Gasly pass on the straight. He was in any case going to have DRS on me, so there was no point in holding up these two Red Bulls. So here I just put the car down into lean mixture and none on the ERS, and there goes Pierre Gasly right past me. And guys, because there's no point in battling these guys, I need to save my tires and also need to go as far as possible. So yeah, heading on to the end of lap 14, guys, we finally come in for our pit stop. And guys, I have to be honest, I wish I came in a lap earlier, because this final lap before I came into the pit lane, my tires were falling off of the cliff. There was no grip left and I actually lost a lot of time for that, just that one extra lap that I tried to gamble. And for this Grand Prix, my gamble has not worked out. We are on to a set of hard tires, taking this car to the end of the Grand Prix. And now let's hope we can get the track position when the other cars come in for their second pit stops. You guys can see finally Sebastian Vettel is going to come in for his pit stop. I do not know how these Ferraris make their tires last so good. The Ferrari has a brilliant chassis on F1 2019, and these guys just make their tires last so good, it's not even funny. So that was Vettel coming in. The end of lap 16 is only the lap that Charles Leclerc is coming in. But at this stage, Hamilton has already caught up to Charles Leclerc, and Hamilton is going to pass Charles. And Ferrari, guys, I think it's quite clear that the two-stop is the way to go. And not just Ferrari, but I myself have made a massive mistake. The wear here at Canada is just too bad to just stay out on the mediums and the hards. The two-stop is the way to go. But guys, I've already committed to the strategy. Let's make of it what we can and just try and bring home a little bit of points. This is Bottas going on to his second set of mediums. You guys can see even my teammate has caught up to me and is now passing me. So I am basically a sitting duck. There's nothing I can do about it. Guys, I am utterly useless at this stage on those hard compound tires. They are terrible here at Canada. So note to self, never use the hard compound of tire again on F1 2019 when you race at Canada. Oh, no. Come on, this sucks. Oh, guys, and look, even Hamilton has built up such a gap. Even Vettel, who has jumped Charles Leclerc in the pit lane phases, he is going to not be close to Hamilton. Well, wait. He might be. Heading to T1. Nope, he's not. He's not. Hamilton is ahead, and Hamilton is going to have so much fresher tires. And guys, this is Bottas just making his way back up the rankings. He is right behind Charles Leclerc. And this, I think, is going to be a fairly easy pass for the second Finn. He is on the inside for the second part of the chicane. Oh, he bounces the car a little bit rough there over the inside curb there of the chicane. And Valtteri is through on Charles Leclerc. Nothing that Charles could do on those more worn, harder tyres against the fresh mediums. And now you guys can see lap 25 are going to run through the top 10. It is Lewis Hamilton still dominating this Grand Prix from Sebastian Vettel. He is being caught very quickly from Valtteri Bottas in third. Fourth place is brought up by the second Ferrari of Charles Leclerc. Fifth place is actually not a Red Bull. It is the frickin' Racing Point of Lucas Weber. How? Damn, this guys, give that man a belt. He is really, man, he's driving good. Max Verstappen is in P6 with Pierre Gasly P7. Eighth place, it is actually Sergio Perez. So you guys can see it's a Mercedes versus Ferrari, Red Bull versus Racing Point battle here. In ninth place, it is my teammate Romain Grosjean. And bringing up the rear end of the top 10, it is myself. So guys, we at this stage, we are only going to receive one measly point, but it's better than nothing. So we have to defend for the rest of this Grand Prix as if our lives depend on it. And now Valtteri Bottas has finally caught up to Sebastian Vettel at the end of lap 27, and I think he does exactly the same to Vettel that he did to Charles. And Valtteri is through on Sebastian Vettel, and Valtteri, it's now going to be a Mercedes 1-2 for this Grand Prix. There's nothing that Ferrari is going to be able to do about it, even though those hard tyres last long. Those medium tyres to grip are just too superior. Guys, then you got to the end. Well, I don't know, that must have been lap 26, because now we're on lap 27. And now Devin Butler is trying to go head to head with me. I still don't like this guy. Oh, the memories from Formula 2 will stick with you forever. He goes for a massive dive up the inside of my car, heading into the final hairpin, guys. Guys, I was going to defend this P10 with everything I got. You guys know I can be fairly strong when it comes to defending, and I was not just going to let these guys breeze past. It is Devin Butler, Carlos Sainz, and Kimi Raikkonen hounding me from behind. And there's, in the corners, I just don't have the grip, guys. In the straight line, I've got the speed with the Haas, with the Haas having the Ferrari motor in the back, but still, the corners, I was just absolutely pathetic. Here you guys can see I actually got away from them a bit, because Kimi and Carlos are starting to pressure Devin, and now Ricardo, and I can't see who was there at the back, all caught up to this group. So it has given me a little bit of breathing room, but I don't think it's going to be long until, yes, this happens. Kimi Raikkonen is going for a move on Devin Butler. Kimi, stay behind him. Please stay behind him. I don't have the grip, man. I need the points, man. All of these guys need the points. Oh, Lando Norris, and I think it's Danny Kavir that has caught up to the back of the train. But Kimi Raikkonen has passed Devin Butler and is now coming after me at lightning speed. Yippee. But guys, we jump onto the end of, I think this is lap, I can't remember, guys, but Lewis Hamilton is going to win the Canadian Grand Prix in a dominant fashion. His teammate Valtteri Bottas is going to come through in P2. It's a Mercedes domination here at Canada. And in third place, it'll be Sebastian Vettel coming home to get Ferrari at least on the podium. But guys, we are at this stage battling away with Kimi Raikkonen. And at this stage, Kimi is hounding us as well as... that's Carlos Sainz! Oh, guys, we've got two cars to worry about. It's a Haas, an Alfa Romeo, and a McLaren fighting for the final point here in Canada. We are going to have to do something amazing at this stage. My teammate has just bolted away. He's not even near me. And guys, this we have to do something. We have to do something. I try and get my wheel as straight as possible to get the run out of the final hairpin. But Kimi is going to have DRS on me. I saved some ERS. We are in overtake mode, rich on the fuel mixture. You guys can see we have barely any fuel left. But guys, we are going to defend P10 until we get to the very, very final part of this race. And we will take home a solid 1 point. Oh, damn.
Sorry about that. I guess it can't all go to plan. Bring her in. We'll go over what happened in the debrief.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
So, let's review the driver's standings. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to O'Connor. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximised their potential.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts.
You scraped the walls a few times. Were you struggling for grip? Do you have any comments about the collisions?
Well, thanks anyway.
Guys, what a Canadian Grand Prix. A little bit disappointing for ourselves. We officially know Canada is a two-stop strategy type of track. And yeah, that was not a good Grand Prix from my side. It was still a very action-packed Grand Prix, I have to say that. But damn, I can't believe the Hards are such a bad tire at Canada. Guys, it's like on F1 2018 at Silverstone. Remember, you had the yellow-walled soft tyre, the white-walled medium, and the blue-walled hard. Now, that hard tyre, you could just as well put the car in semi-slicks. They were pathetic. And the hard tyres at Canada feel exactly like that. So, I'm really disappointed about this Grand Prix, but we still came away with points. It's nothing too bad. So, guys, we are going to head to the upgrades, and we're going to put on a few upgrades on the car. We're going to get back that engine upgrade that failed as we got into this episode, and I think we're going to go for a chassis upgrade, maybe, or an aero upgrade. I'm not sure. But, guys, you guys watch the screen to see what upgrade we do. Guys, that has been this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, hit the subscribe, don't forget to ding the bell, and if you enjoyed it as much as I did, please share it with your friends. And I'll see y'all for the next one in France.
Cheers!